Disabilities Bill was introduced in Parliament in February 2014. The bill was referred to the Standing Committee. The Standing Committee is a smaller group of MPs who read the bill in detail and make suggestions. They can also call for comments from the public on the bill. After receiving comments, the Standing Committee can also invite some persons who have given the comments. The Standing Committee met several organizations in Delhi and in Chennai. The committee then makes a report which is presented in the Parliament. These are a few highlights of the Standing Committee report on the Disabilities Bill. There is a list of disabilities in the bill. The committee felt like more disabilities should be added, like kidney failure, blood cancer, diabetes type 1, dwarfism, epilepsy, stroke and paralysis, and spinal cord injuries. The committee suggested to change the name of the bill to the Rights of Persons with Different Abilities or Special Abilities. The bill right now does not apply to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. The committee wants the bill to extend to Jammu and Kashmir as well. People with disabilities face many barriers which are recognized in the bill. The committee wants to include attitudes and psychological barriers to this list. Communication under the bill has a definition which does not include sign language and video and visual displays. The committee suggested that inclusion of sign language and video is important. The bill has provisions on making establishments accessible. However, the bill only limits establishments to government bodies and buildings. The committee felt that because government has a limited role and now most things are done by private sector, the definition of establishment should extend to private sector. The committee also wants public building to be defined matter who owns it, which is used by the public. If it is for education, work, business, religion, cultural, recreational, health, medicine, courts, police stations, jails. It also includes all transport systems, air, water, road, and rail, and the infrastructure around these systems. It also includes communication methods like telecom, internet, digital, and print. Lastly, it includes all services like housing, education, employment, shopping, religion, recreational, insurance, banking, postal, and access to justice. In the definition of reasonable accommodation, the UNCRPD says that it should be adjustments and modification which does not impose a undue burden. The committee recommended the removal of the term undue burden because it may be a loophole for the authorities to escape. The UNCRPD also defines discrimination on the basis of disability. This definition is not there in the Disabilities Bill. The committee has suggested that this is included. The committee also wants to define words like abuse, exploitation, violence, and hate speech in the bill, along with rehabilitation. Habilitation should also be included in the bill. Because of the double discrimination faced by women and girls with disabilities, the committee has suggested a separate chapter be included on their rights. The bill says no person with disability shall be discriminated on the ground of disability unless it is shown that the act is appropriate to achieve a legitimate aim. The committee felt that the exception to achieve a legitimate aim means that the bill does not recognize the right to equality of persons with disabilities. It also curtails even the constitutional right to equality. Therefore, it should be changed. Persons with disabilities will be given free legal aid, but the committee also wants them to be given expenses, transport allowance, and assistance in communication. On legal capacity, the committee wants to ensure that persons with disabilities enjoy legal capacity on an equal basis with others. It also stated that deaf persons can record witness statements in sign language. The committee felt that provisions relating to guardianship may be going against right to equality. Therefore, the ministry has been told to revisit guardianship issues and invite views of NGOs on the issue. Education, buildings, campuses, and facilities, including technology, toilets, drinking water, should be made accessible. Kits, aids, and appropriate therapies like speech therapy and occupational therapy for inclusive education should be made available free of cost. Teachers with disabilities and teachers who teach disabilities should be paid equal grade and salary as given to other teachers of the school, including those teachers who teach children between age of 3 and 6. All children with disabilities should get free education and learning materials and assistive devices till they complete their education. In exams, there should be suitable modifications like giving extra time, facility of scribe, and exemption from second and third language. In skill development, training and schemes should be in an accessible environment. Skill training for disabled persons should be provided which suits them, as links with the market, and also gives adequate support, including access to finance. In employment, government should be careful that authorities may misuse provisions which exempt them from hiring persons with disabilities. Provisions regarding posting and transfer of persons with disabilities in government jobs should allow persons with disabilities to live close to their native home. must provide reasonable accommodation and barrier-free environment to employees with disabilities. Social security. All social security and other schemes are supposed to be within the limit of the economic capacity of the government, according to the bill. The committee has asked to remove this limit in the bill, and instead it should be to the maximum resources. Basic social security like food, shelter, clothing, health care should be provided to persons with disabilities free of cost without being subject to income ceiling, like above poverty line. Unemployment allowance should be given for a period of 5 years. All hospitals, private, public, or charity, should provide barrier-free access to persons with disabilities. Income ceiling should be removed for provision of health care. Insurance companies should not be allowed to charge any higher premium for disabled persons compared to other people. Culture and recreation. The provisions relating to culture and recreation should also promote deaf culture and access to more TV programs with sign language, interpreters and subtitles. Education for children with benchmark disabilities. Benchmark disabilities is someone with more than 40% of a disability. Free preschool education before the age of 6 years should be given. Children should be given the choice between inclusive and special education. Upper age relaxation of 5 years for disabled persons and their children for admission in higher education. Free education should be given to the age of 21 instead of 18 years, as persons with disabilities may take more time to complete their education. Reservations in government jobs. The committee has asked Ministry of Social Justice, Department of Personnel and Training to come up with the final decision on reservations in government jobs. National Commission under this law will have powers to review the vacancies for different disabilities. Private sector must be given specific incentives to employ persons with disabilities to motivate private sector to give suitable employment. provisions for persons with high support needs. The term high support needs should be removed and replaced with support needs for persons with benchmark disabilities. Applications to the assessment board for support should be completed quickly. Duties of the government. The rights of persons with disabilities should be taught in schools, colleges, and universities. The bill provides that public buildings should be made accessible within 5 years, and this time period can be extended. The committee says that all small infrastructure like toilets and smaller facilities must be completed within 5 years, and only for large infrastructure should there be exception. Private sector also should be asked to make infrastructure accessible. Disability certificates. Issuance of disability certificates should be time bound and valid throughout the country, across all departments, and for all purposes. The rules with regard to certification should be completed as soon as possible. National Commission for Disabilities. At least 2 of the 3 members in the National Commission should be from persons with disabilities. One member should preferably be a woman with a disability. No member should be disqualified because of physical or mental incapacity. The special court should be renamed as Disability Rights Tribunal. The bill has a national fund for persons with disabilities. The committee suggests that a state fund should also be available. The bill allows for women with severe disabilities to be forced to undergo abortion, even if they do not agree. These medical procedures affect the dignity of the women and girls, and so the committee asked the ministry to redraft this provision. State governments have to frame rules under this law. This must be done in a time-bound manner. The transgender community should be included in the provisions under this law. If this law is in conflict with any law that restricts the rights of persons with disabilities, then this law should be given more importance. In case any disability is referred to by a different name in this bill compared to 1995 Act, then there should be no problem with the existing disability certificate. A disability budget must be allocated to all ministries, departments, organizations at state and central level, including panchayat and district. The government should provide a platform for active political participation of PWD and encourage them to be a part of policy making at panchayat and district level. Public-private partnerships should be encouraged in private healthcare, and tax concessions on treatments of PWD should be given. National Commission and State Commission should have websites and accessible websites giving details of the complaints and cases pending with them. The cases before the special court should be taken in a specific time frame, maximum of 1 year. The penalty for offenses should be increased. Discrimination in employment should be fined by 10 lakhs. Discrimination in school should result in revoking the license of the school. If buildings or vehicles do not comply with accessibility rules, there should be a fine. A fund should be created for disability insurance and payroll deduction can support the cost of this. Inclusive education of persons with disabilities should be exclusively monitored by the education department. The HRD ministry should make it mandatory to integrate disabled children in mainstream education. Service animals like dogs should be provided to PWDs, especially for the blind and hearing impaired. They should be allowed to enter all public buildings along with the PWDs. The financial memorandum with the bill does not give a specific amount needed for execution of the scheme. This needs to be specified. An interdepartmental committee with the members of various ministries like education, health, women, child development should be discussed prior to this new law. Community and family model for development and rehabilitation of PWDs should be preferred to institutions and special centers to allow for overall development of disabled persons in society. The government must create awareness about the Act. Efforts should be made to give information about the Act through the regional and national channels on TV government should ensure that other laws are amended, especially when they govern the life, education and rights of persons with disabilities. Leprosy cured people should be given specific housing, as they are often not allowed to live in other colonies because of discrimination. Persons with disabilities should be able to get pension, and there should be no rules like saying that there is any income ceiling or that the person should be only below poverty line. The term hearing impairment should be replaced with the term deafness and hard of hearing, which has been suggested by the deaf community. The definition and rules on certification of deafness and hard of hearing should be drafted in consultation with the disabled person. To conclude, the committee is very, very particular that this law should be very, very carefully drafted to guarantee security, safety, health and welfare of persons with disabilities, and also facilitate their growth and empowerment. This report is now placed in Parliament. The Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment will examine the report. They may accept all of the provisions in the report. They may accept some and reject some. They may reject the report totally. But there are some places where definitely the committee has suggested that the community gets involved, like legal capacity, like defining deafness, hard of hearing, like other provisions. Therefore, we should start work towards responding to this report and ensuring that final recommendations and changes are made to make this a very meaningful law for not only the deaf community, but also all persons.